Hi, welcome back to the Fierce Kittens channel. Today we're going to learn how to do a welt zippered pocket. You may have noticed that a lot of bag patterns these days have these zippered pockets in them, and you might be wondering how the heck they do it so cleanly without having puckered corners or really wobbly top stitching. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how I prefer to do these kinds of pockets step by step, and hopefully we can get you to a point where you feel comfortable sewing these welt zippered pockets. So let's get started. So for this tutorial, you're going to need your pocket lining pieces. One of them at least should be interfaced. Now, I don't always interface the back piece. That is completely up to you. I find that it adds a lot of bulk if I do interface it. The interfacing I used here was woven fuse, number one. Then you're going to have your main piece. This can actually be your interior lining, or it could be your exterior, a flat piece, wherever the zipper is going to be installed to. And that also needs to be interfaced. And this I also just used woven fuse one for the example. You're going to need a zipper. You need at least about 5 inches, but I have like these extra long zippers. And for today's example, I am just going to use a regular dress zipper, one that you could get at a craft store, because not everybody has access to number 5 zippers, so I wanna make sure this is accessible. You need something to mark with, whether it be a disappearing ink pen or actually just a ballpoint pen. The lines that you're going to be making on this are not gonna be visible, so I will actually just use my ballpoint pen. And you're going to need some kind of straight measuring implement, preferably like a little ruler, something that is transparent that you can see through so you can keep tab of your lines. First, you're going to take your lining piece that was interfaced, and you're going to flip it over to the wrong side. You're going to get your marking utensil, and you're going to get your ruler. And what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to make a 1/2 inch high box, and then whatever width you need for your zipper. And in this case, I wanna make sure that I'm at least 3/4 of an inch from the edge. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna go ahead and kind of gently brush down to make a mark. That was not terribly gently brushed, but whatever. I'm just gonna mark that 3/4 of an inch area, because what I wanna do is make sure that I have enough leeway on the side here for me to be able to stitch the other lining back to this later. And then do the same across the top as well. So this is kind of considered your no man's land where you don't want to put the zipper. So there you have basically the top line for your zipper pocket. Now what you want to do is go 1/2 inch below that, and here's why I said to get a transparent ruler like this, because you can basically just go ahead and flip it this way and line up that first line to the 1/2 inch mark and then draw. If you can't do that, if you don't have a way to do it, or you don't have like this fancy OmniGrid thing down here, or actually it's a Fiskars self-healing mat, you can just measure and mark 1/2 inch little divots and then connect the dots. You really can do that. But these guys are super helpful, so highly recommend that you get something like that. Now, once you have this little 1/2 inch pocket kind of worked out, you're gonna grab your main fabric and you're going to put it right side up. Now, your pattern will guide you on where you're supposed to be putting this. For example's sake, I'm not actually gonna care. I'm just gonna put my marked lining fabric for the pocket right side down. So you should have right sides together always in this case. And I'm just gonna like kind of top center it like this, or rather center the lining piece to my example piece. Again, like I said, your pattern will actually tell you where you need to be putting this. Then I'm gonna take 2 pins and just put it one along the top, smooth down, and put it down here at the bottom. And that's just gonna secure it in place for when we go to sew it. Now here's the trick. A lot of people in patterns, and I am actually guilty of this as well, they're gonna tell you that you need to sew around the box. Here's something that I have learned just in the past month. Don't sew around the whole box. Only sew from the top line across. Cut your thread. and then sew just along the bottom line and don't touch this section here. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and draw in the middle here my little cut points. Now, you can also use a ruler for this as well. I tend to just eyeball this part here because it doesn't really matter. This is the line where we're gonna cut later. And then these little corner pieces here will end up being folded back this way. But the problem is that if you sew around here on this, these side seams, it's gonna cause it to bunch up. And so you find yourself clipping closer and closer and closer to this corner point. And eventually, and I mean, lots of times I've done this, I accidentally cut through and then I ruin the pocket entirely, or I use liberal amounts of fray check to fix my problem. So you don't wanna do that. So let's not be like me. And so we're just gonna sew across this top line and this bottom line. So now you're at your machine, you're going to carefully take your needle and line it up with that end point that we had kind of marked in the previous step. Put your needle halfway down, and what you're gonna do is you're gonna stitch forward a few stitches and then stitch backwards. I didn't realize my hand covered up the needle when I was going backwards here, so I'm sorry. In subsequent steps, I stopped doing stupid things. But now you're just gonna stitch all the way down, following that line and avoiding pins. Now, when you get to the bottom, slow up and make sure the needle is in that last dot and then go backwards to secure it. I don't suggest doing what your machines usually have as like a lock stitch method to go ahead and like tie off stitching. Those are actually pretty weak when it comes to having to turn things right side out, and you're gonna find some stray threads in there. So again, stitching forward a couple of stitches, stitching backwards a couple of stitches, I feel is a lot stronger. You're gonna finish off the stitch by going all the way to the bottom and then basically doing the exact same thing. Okay, now that you are done sewing along just the top and bottom long edges, you're gonna come over to your cutting table once more. And I find that it helps to take like a rotary blade and just kinda pop the initial hole in there in the middle. I don't usually suggest taking the rotary blade and going all the way through. I actually come back through with scissors, and that's only because I get so scared that I'm just going to clip straight through and goof something up. So you're gonna cut away that middle line, just like that, up to the point where you've made the little triangles. Then you're going to clip up to, but not through the top line. I mean, it's the same as before, but you're not so worried about a secondary line here and clipping like an actual like seam. So, clipping like so. And so now you have an open hole and you're freaking out. Ah, because it's an open hole. So now you're gonna take this and you're gonna flip it to the inside. Just like this. Only hopefully a little less messy. So you can already see there's a lot less puckering going on right here in the corners. And that, and what little puckering you do have is going to be ironed out. So we'll go back over to this side and see if it's just as good. And sometimes you may find you'll have to come back over it, and that's all right. Sometimes the clipping is not perfect. Like on this side, it really wasn't. Oh my gosh, it's so hard to demonstrate this. It's like, I don't wanna sit still. So we're gonna flip it back over. And this is just like me eyeballing it. And of course, I probably would have been helpful had I used a darker thread, but I'm just gonna clip up a little more, again, not through any of the lines that I've made, but just up to them. There you go. Okay, so now we're back to looking pretty darn nice. So let's make it even cleaner. Okay, so one of my friends on Twitch, Lady Crafts, turned me on to this idea of using a book binder to help to straighten out the edges once you get them kind of flipped to the wrong side. So you see the lining of the pocket is basically going to be right side up once you start flipping things. And you can get it kind of lazy pressed. And this is actually more important of a technique when you're using heavier fabrics than these lighter weight fabrics. These two cottons are gonna press just fine with an iron. But what she told me to do is to come in here with the bookbinder and kind of mark the edge, just kind of score it a little bit right in the seam, and that'll help it lay flat. I will link to her channel at the bottom because I don't like to take credit for other people's techniques, but it really helps to kind of get that kind of sitting straight, to get all of the edges forcibly pushed out, because sometimes you'll end up like this area here. See, it's kind of bunched up and it's not really fully pushed out. And so we go in here and you're gonna put the bookbinder. You can actually use a point turning tool for this probably as well, and just hold the fabric and push up against the seam. Not too forcibly, you don't want to push through, but now you can see that it's a lot more straight and right there and ready for you to sew, instead of sitting here going and like kind of pushing it down. And then sometimes that can create creasing too. So I usually go in and I take it very far away from the hole as far as I can go, because I'm gonna iron it, but I'll actually pin things down so they kind of stay where they need to be just in the meantime, because I'm gonna go over it with the iron and make it look all nice. So with that said, I'm gonna bring my iron over. If you recall, I use an Ollie Sew Pro, so please don't panic when you see the thing jump down and then jump back up. It's a safety mechanic and it's pretty darn cool. So then I'm just gonna go over, and you can use your precision tip. Most modern irons are gonna have that. Be careful to avoid your pens, because the last thing you wanna do is to melt that plastic ball. But as I get to those areas and I kind of secure them down with the heat, I just take the pins out. So, like that. You may, of course, apply steam liberally as you see fit. Mine takes forever to steam up. I don't know why, but I do try in a video to get it to steam up because it's pretty cool. Okay. And then you can see from there, we have a really nice shaped pocket. No creases in the corners, beautiful work. So let's put the zipper in. One of the things I really like to do with the zipper pockets like this is to use some kind of tape. I prefer to go to a 1/4-inch leather tape that I bought off of Amazon. I will leave the link in the description below. But the reason I like to use this is because it's a lot sturdier and the hold is stronger than what you would find in with a washaway tape. Washaway tape is more or less meant for like garment construction. I use it, it's great for hems. Like if I'm trying to do a hem on like a skirt or something, fine, but I like to use this leather tape. So I flip my work over and I expose the lining of the pocket that's turned to the inside. And then I just put, if I can find the end of it, a strip of the leather tape pretty close to the edge. Not too close, because you don't want it to be visible. And get some scissors and cut that away. And I also put a strip down at the bottom. This stuff does not wash away, but it also shouldn't be visible in the final version, right? So then I peel that off. And I take my zipper, and a lot of people prefer their zippers to open from right to left. So I'm gonna take the zipper like this, right side up. I'm gonna push the head down and I'm gonna flip it over and I'm gonna put it so that the zipper head is off to the right. And I'm just gonna very gently press that down. You don't wanna hold it down and like push it like the Hulk or anything, because you need to flip this back over. So now we're gonna carefully take everything and flip it back over. and we see that it wasn't really placed very evenly. So now is the time for you to kind of mess around with the zipper teeth to get them laying correctly, so that it's not a crooked zipper in a pocket. And this can take some finagling, so it's understandable. Now is the step for top stitching. And you can see I have a bunch of this left over, by the way. Leave extra zipper tape on until the end and I'll show you why. But now's time for top stitching. I'm going to top stitch on my domestic machine. I'm not gonna top stitch on the Juki. However, normally I would top stitch on the Juki because I use a heavier thread. But even if I am sewing these pockets and I'm sewing the bag using my industrial machine, I'll actually still do the pocket hole on the domestic machine. And the reason for that is really simple. I use a lighter weight thread, and so it's easier for me to flip over, and it doesn't leave as many gaping holes because the needle is smaller. So with that in mind, we're just going full domestic on this one. So let's go ahead and we're gonna top stitch this. For this step, I recommend using a zipper foot. It will let you stitch on either side of the foot and get closer to the edge of the zipper without actually hitting the head of the zipper or the teeth, which would make your top stitch look really wobbly. So that's what I'm gonna put on here. Now, stitching from the topmost corner of the long edge, I'm going to set a stitch length to 3.0 millimeters, or you can go longer if you like as top stitch. Tie off your end, and then all you're going to do is stitch around the edge of the pocket very carefully. Make sure to stay as close to the edge as you can, but without actually hitting the zipper teeth. When you get back to the beginning, make sure to put your needle in and pivot your work so that you're lining up your seams. Stitch forward a little ways and then lock your stitch again. You can also stitch backwards here. That's completely up to you. Free the work from the machine, and there you have a top stitched zipper pocket. Now that you have your top stitch in place, what you're going to do is you're going to flip your work over so that the right side is down on the table and the right side of the pocket lining is facing up. You're going to take your other lining piece, whether it be lined or unlined, and you're going to put it right side down against the pocket. And then you're going to clip or pin along the edge, and only the edge. Do not include that exterior or lining fabric, whichever is the faced fabric. You don't want to pin through that, only through the edges of the pocket. So now you've got it ready to go. We're going to take this over to the machine, and you'll watch my technique at the machine, but basically I'm going to stitch from this side up, but I'm going to move that exterior fabric out of the way. So that I can expose from the bottom. It's a lot easier to stitch that way. If you go like this way, then you may or may not catch this pocket. So this allows me to watch the exterior portion and ensure I don't accidentally catch it in one of the pocket seams. So gently moving back that exterior fabric to expose the two linings for the pockets, we're going to go ahead and start stitching. I have left the zipper foot on, and I find that it is a lot easier for me to work with it this way. It gives me a little more wiggle room. When we get to the zipper teeth, I want you to turn around and backstitch over that, and that's just going to reinforce that stitch. Take your pins or your clips out as you work your way around and sew all the way around the outer edges of the pocket, keeping that fabric out of the way each time you go. All right, now that you're back, you have basically stitched all the way around the pocket edge. I did double stitch here at the zipper ends, and so now it is safe to cut the zipper away. Take some scissors you don't care about. I have some older ones here that I actually use for zippers and webbing. So I'm just gonna very carefully cut that away and toss it. And you're going to want to trim around the edge of the pocket just to reduce the bulk. Like in this particular example, it's not necessary. We're not gonna really be doing anything with it, but it's a good practice to just trim it down. I tend to stitch a quarter inch seam allowance with these lining pockets. I don't like to go much over that, but it does, you know, it does help if you're working with a tight knit project with close space. I would say avoid trimming the top here. If you accidentally snag the zipper, it will cause that zipper tape to fray. But now you're basically done. If you open up your zipper, you can see your pocket. And you can put your hand in your pocket, and it's awesome. So that's it, you got to make a welt zippered pocket. I'm glad that I was able to teach you this neat technique and how to make it so that you don't have puckered corners and a lot of stress in trying to get it to look really pretty from the visible portion. If you can, please like and subscribe. I also stream on Twitch on Mondays, Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Fridays, starting at 9 p.m. Eastern and going until about 11 p.m. Eastern. So if you wanna interact with me live, come on over to Twitch. Thanks.